What's going on, guys? Yes, as you can tell, I am doing a screencast. This is for a distro called Dream Studio. This is done by a single person. He's part of the KX Studio team, which is a multimedia repository. And look it up, you'll find more information on it. But basically what this distro boils down to is that the person that makes this distro is a content creator that uses all Linux. Everything he does is Linux based. Music, video, audio, you know, whatever. Photography, it's all Linux based. So this is very content creator focused, which I love. This is the type of distros that I love reviewing, the type of distros that I love going over, because this is very much up my alley. This is very much up the way I like to do things. So it has a lot of stuff that normally I bitch and moan about in Linux that defaultly a lot of the distros just don't have. So now to get into the meat and potatoes of the distribution. First off, yes, it's 11.04 based, so you can still use GNOME 2.0 classic fallback mode, whatever you want to call it, instead of the Unity interface. This is just defaultly what they use, so this is just what I went with. Now, as far as what comes pre-installed, first off, the low latency Linux 3.0 kernel is used defaultly. You have Jack essentially set up so that it is plug and play, which I love because I always say Jack is a pain in the ass to set up. Some of the audio programs, I'm not going to give a complete rundown of these because they are way too many. You have Auditor with a customized UI. You have Audacity. These are all defaultly installed. You have Beast. Blender is pre-installed. Some of the other applications for video, you have three different video editors with varying degrees of not usability, but functionality. You have Cinelear, which is pre-installed, which is very rarely ever pre-installed on any distro I've used. You have Lives, which is more of a video DJ program, but you can use it for video editing as well. Then you have OpenShot, which is pre-installed. For photos, you have GIMP pre-installed. You have your Lightroom equivalent, which would be Darktable. The list goes on and on and on. There's just so many things. Inkscape is pre-installed. There are some discrepancies on the content creation. Some of the things that are missing that I've noticed, now these are just quick things that I've noticed, is it doesn't defaultly have a video capture of the desktop. So I had to download Kazam because I just find it works better for screencasting. And there is no Cheese or GUVC view defaultly installed. Some of the other programs, you have Composer pre-installed, Hydrogen, which is a drum machine. Like I said, the list is just massive of what's actually on here. So if you are a content creator on Linux, I would really, really recommend taking a look at this distro. Even if you do not like the deb format, just this distribution in general is so geared to content creation that you would be a fool to overlook it because of the person that makes this does everything that they create on Linux. So it is very focused on that niche and that market. And as someone that falls into that market, this is the type of distro I love. So every distro has its issues, but I can overlook that just given the love and care that goes into something like this. So for a content creator, 10 out of 10 easy. As someone who's just like, it would be distro hopping, depends on how you like your desktop environments. Unity, you either love it or hate it. And if you need a GNOME 2.0 distro that's still got another year of support, well, this is probably your distro to go to. So that's my review, guys. That's my overview of it. Rate it, subscribe it. Peace.